Okay, on the left, we've got the great Ben Hogan rear view here, angled from the rear. And let's take a look at his backswing. You know, there's the loading motion, and I want to talk about a position here about what his right hip does in the direction his hip pocket will travel during his backswing. So his right hip works back toward the target, his hips turn. Now, this is the motion I'm talking about, reestablishing, settling weight back on the lead foot. So it's pretty easy to see that his hips are turned whatever amount of degrees. And then this is the motion of resettling those closed hips a fraction before everything starts to work down. So it's pretty easy to see his hips have moved out of that green box to the left toward the target a little bit. They've settled onto his lead foot in what I consider to be somewhat turned or closed position. And then from there, there's a lot of reaction from the ground pushing up out of the left leg that helps him deliver a golf club from the inside, even though he had fades. And, you know, it's quite easy to see now where his hips are relative to where they started. They're well left outside that original green box. On the right screen here, we have a modern day, highly regarded swinger in Grant Waite. And his hips turn very similar to Hogan's. His right hip turns. His hips turn in that box, and then his transition move, his closed hips resettle a little bit onto his lead foot. And that's something you see. This is not what you see amateurs do. They're spinning their hips out prior to this reestablishing move. Once they're reestablished in that closed position, his hands can, you know, work down. Before they work around, his hips are well out of that box. And I can draw another hip-to-hip and straight-down box in this condition here to recognize that, pretty easy to see, and then into impact and to follow through, excellent golf swing. So I hope that helps.